Dimensional analysis. In the previous video, we have learned about dimensions of physical quantities. Now in this video, we will understand its few important points when we are dealing with dimensions. First, dimensional analysis tells us that only those physical quantities can be added or subtracted which have same dimensions. For example, length of rectangle and breadth of rectangle can be added or subtracted because length and breadth have same dimensions, that is L. However, velocity cannot be added to temperature because they have different dimensions. Second, dimensional analysis helps in identification of relation between different physical quantities. For example, volume of a cube is a physical quantity. Its relation with another physical quantity, length, can be identified by the relation V equals to L to the power 3. Third, when two or more physical quantities are multiplied, then their dimensions must be multiplied in the same way as that of ordinary algebraic calculations. For example, pressure equals to force upon area. Let us try to find the dimensions of pressure. P equals to mLt to the power minus 2 upon L to the power 2, which is equals to mL to the power minus 1 t to the power minus 2, since L upon L to the power minus 2 equal to L to the power 1 minus 2, which is equals to L to the power minus 1. 4. For various mathematical expressions, dimension analysis helps to check the derivation, accuracy, and dimensional consistency. For example, let us check the correctness of the equation V equals to V0 plus A into T, where V is final velocity, V0 is initial velocity, A is acceleration, and T is time. So, the dimension of final velocity V equals to m to the power 0 L T to the power minus 1. Call this as equation number 1. Dimension of initial velocity V0 will be given by m to the power 0 L T to the power minus 1. Call this as equation number 2. And dimension of AT equals to m to the power 0 L T to the power minus 2 into m to the power 0 L to the power 0 into T, which gives m to the power 0 L T to the power minus 1. Call this as equation number 3. So from equation 1, 2 and 3, the dimensions are equal. Hence, we can say that equation is dimensionally correct.